Good day everyone. Assalamu alaikum. Ohayo gozaimasu. My name is Shoaib Haider. I'm the country director for Hope 87. I'm today going to talk about the Afghan refugees in Pakistan. Pakistan has been hosting Afghan refugees ever since the invasion of Afghanistan by the Soviet Union and Russia back in 1979. Through multiple waves of displacement, we have seen the number of Afghan refugees fluctuate in Pakistan up to a maximum of 5 million people. At this point in time, there are close to 3 million Afghan refugees in Pakistan. This includes all the people who have the official refugee status. Then there are Afghan citizens who do not have refugee status, but they have been given some kind of documentation to recognize their nationalities as displaced Afghans. And then there is a smaller number of undocumented displaced people from Afghanistan, who at the same time are also perhaps the most vulnerable. Ever since the dramatic events which we all saw in Kabul in the middle of August 2021, there has been a steady stream of new arrivals as well. As of end of 2021, according to UNHCR estimates, this number of new Afghan refugees or new Afghan arrivals in Pakistan stands at about 80,000 people. The needs among these Afghan refugees, both the new arrivals and the old Afghan refugees, the livelihood remains the biggest gap and the biggest demand among these communities. Followed by livelihoods, cash support primarily to cover the rent of houses as shelter is the second biggest demand. This is followed by education and health, as these are the basic needs and services that is required by the Afghan refugees. In this context, for more than a decade now, Hope 87 has been working with the Afghan refugees in the fields of education and health. For the health, we have received great and generous support from the citizens of Hiroshima, from Aunt Hiroshima, and not to forget Ueno-san, who has been the biggest contributor to help us set up a basic health unit in Shamshatu near Peshawar city. Apart from this, Hope 87 is also supporting the Afghan children through different education interventions by setting up dedicated schools for Afghan children, as well as supporting the registration and enrollment of Afghan children in the formal schools as well as in non-formal schools. We need to support the Afghan communities in a sustainable manner so that they can earn their own livelihoods in a dignified manner, and so that they can contribute to the economic development of the host country, which is Pakistan, as well as in a manner that at the time when they go back, they are able to support the economy of Afghanistan as well. I call upon all the participants and the listeners to do your part in raising this issue and help the Afghan refugees in Pakistan. Thank you very much. Arigato gozaimasu.